The trio of the 32 National Unity Platform supporters accused of being in possession of explosives was set to kick off today at the General Court Martial chaired by Brigadier General Freeman Robert Mugabe. However, the court could not proceed with the trial as prosecution revealed that their first witness could not make it to court. Seemingly angered by the statement, the accused persons started shouting on top of their voices, accusing the Army Court of failing to avail them justice and deliberately keeping them in jail for no reason. These were led by Muhuddin Kakoza, who had recently attempted to attack former military court chairperson, Lieutenant General Andrew Guti. He outrightly accused the state of political persecution. Left with no option, the suspects were forcefully taken out of court. The case was also adjourned to the 21st of February 2023. Prosecution alleges that between November 2020 and May 2021, the suspects were in possession of explosives, mainly the bombs, which are a monopoly of the armed forces. Still in court, 18-year-old Queen Kafta, charged with aggravated torture and causing grievous harm to her teenage friend over a lover, has been sentenced to serve 3 years in prison. In her plea, Kafta had informed court that she is a student and asked for a lighter sentence, most preferably communal service. However, Pretty Nicole, the complainant, asked court to jail Kafta for 5 years. Kafta was today sentenced by Kira Court Chief Magistrate Rosalind Nsenge after she pleaded guilty to the offense. Nsenge notes that the sentence of 3 years is to serve as a lesson to the convict and to deter other would-be offenders from committing the same offense. Kafta committed the offense on January 8, 2023 at Nsasa Zone in Kira Municipality.